tend not to use ladders that have consequences. Consequence ladders are the ones that have this slat is made out of plastic. Because if you hit the plastic, you go, whoosh. Is it terrible if you have that? No, it's not. Certainly, you don't want to use the ones that have the rung around it that's a piece of plastic. It's an actual tube on top of it. If you use those, you're basically asking for it in terms of people slipping, falling, breaking their wrists. Hello, nice to see you again. Okay. No, it's all good. So I tend to use these ladders. This is a double length ladder. So the regular length is just half of this. And so when you buy a ladder, typically it's this full length right here. I'm pretty sure you guys have ladders in all your kits. They get messed up over time, and you can have it on a floor. You can even have the rubber slats if you want. If you don't have a ladder, you can use pylons and have a leader. Okay, and then everybody just follows the leader after a certain amount of time. So we're going to do some basic ladder drills. So why doesn't everybody get up and come on out over here? And keep your writing stuff nearby, but I'm going to talk you through them. Come on down, line up at this end. The ladder sequence that I'm giving you today is actually thought out such that it goes from smaller movements to bigger movements. So let's everybody get this down here. Who's the hero who wants to go first?
Steve right here.
Okay. You know what? I'll take, who's done ladders with me before? Either of you two? No? You haven't though, right? Neither? Okay, come on over. So here we go. So I'm just gonna make sure everybody understands these. The sequence, I've got a bunch of ladder ones here. These are really good for developing. If you keep passing people through the ladder and you do these things, great benefit. So the first one is in, out, out. And I'm pretty sure everybody knows that one. So first things, if you have a team that doesn't know ladder drills, I typically have a pylon about this far so that, because if you have somebody coming up behind you, that's called time pressure. Time pressure is a different thing. That's a good thing to have later on. But right now you say, don't move until that pylon's there. Make sense? And then if you have an athlete who does this really well, lead them out. Because if I do something in front of him, he's going to be able to follow with me. That's in, out, out. So literally go ahead, in, out, out. In, out, out. In, out, out. In, out, out. Stop. The cueing is very important. You should verbalize in, out, out. In, out, out. In, out, out. In, out, out. Don't get shy with that because people just don't understand that. You should have a secondary ladder here. For the person who has less motor coordination than the regular group, who are special in your group, we could have the ladder where people can learn the skill separately. You don't want to stop the ladder. They learn it pretty quickly. So we go in, out, out, in, out, out, in, out, out. That's a temporal cue, okay? They start off there. So everybody's going to go through once, in, out, out, and following our rules. So everybody line up here. Everybody does it once, just so you get it. And now here's the next cue as soon as you go ahead. In, out, out, in, out, out, in, out, out, in, out, out. Stop. Everybody listen up. Stop. If you're doing this drill, it is inappropriate to ask the person to look up. Do not cue them to look up. They should be looking down hard to learn that skill. And as they go through 5 to 7 practices of this, then you can ask them to start looking up and forward. Do not over cue and try to make them look up at this stage. And then if their hands are behind their back, whatever, if they're doing the spaz arm, whatever they're doing, it doesn't matter. You let that happen. Later on, you want them to become fluid as they move, okay? So let's go, cue it up. In, out, out, in, out, out, in, out, out, in, out, out. Go for it. I'm gonna. Go for it.
Go team.
There we go, nicely done. It's hard. In, out, out, 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 in, out, out. And stop. The next cue that you have, for you guys, I don't have to do it, but if I had an expert ladder runner, the statement I have to make, especially as soon as somebody hits the ladder, is accuracy first, speed second. I do not want ladder hits, so it is inappropriate to hit the ladder, so we say accuracy first, speed second. Cue it up, ready, go. In and out, out, 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 in and out, out. In and out, out, 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 in and out, out. In and out, out, in and out, out. See, it's hard. No, it's okay. Speed second. There we go. Nicely done. And we'll just wait. Okay, everybody's got that? Everybody fan out for a second, and just so you can see me here. If I'm a national team coach looking for movement, and I often will have coaches standing beside me as I'm running people through drills, and they're looking for the quality of movement as a person moves through here, the big thing that you want to cue your athletes is that you really don't want to be going out, out, in, out, out. It's going to be as close to the rungs as possible. And you want to move along there like a flying little butterfly. So you keep your feet in, not out. All right, not big, big, out, out. So those are things you can cue as they go down. That's about it. And then gradually what'll happen is they'll get used to it. They'll get relaxed in the upper arms. The arms will become like this instead of like this. And then they'll move along like little bees as we go. The next one is Icky Shuffle. The cueing technique for Icky Shuffle while we're here is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So you stand off to the side of the ladder. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I'll do that again slowly. Stand off to the side of the ladder and watch the foot movement here. It's 1, 2, sorry. I just spazzed out. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. You don't step out with this. This one then advances. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So you don't step right outside the ladder. Everybody tends to do that, so try not to. Ready? Icky Shuffle, I-C-K-Y Shuffle. Ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, speed it up. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, there we go. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, don't just step out so far. Think about moving forward faster. There you go, that's it, forward faster. Instead of stepping out wide, forward faster. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, there you go. That's it, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And stop. The other cue that you want to have at some stage is the real way to do this. If you'll notice, your belly button is going in and outside of the ladder. The people who do this really well, their belly button stays right down the middle of the ladder. Try it again. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I know, that's okay, 1, 2, 3. So your legs are doing the movement, not your body. That's good, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Tia? Stop for a second. Go right in front of him. Quick, Tia. And that's right. And then show. Follow her. Slow it down. Go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Go. Speed it up. Okay, faster. There we go. Okay, pull it straight. 1, 2, 3, not forward, not lateral. That's good, perfect, that's good, 1, 2, 3. Keep saying it in your head, keep saying it in your head. That's perfect. Okay, next one. Scissors, here's how they work. You take your lead leg, everybody be able to see me here. So I have my one foot in here, just like Mexican hat dance. My lead leg, which is the leg that's going to be going the ladder, is on this side. And what you do is you go switch, replace. That foot goes there, switch, replace. Switch, replace, switch, replace, switch, replace, all the way down. So cue it up. And then you can come right back, whoa. I'm going to tell you right now, what you can do is he can actually come right back down the ladder on the opposite side. And then you have actual ability to have contact, which is okay, because that's the game. But that's more advanced. Ready? Go.
Switch.
Replace. That's it. Go. There we go. Boom, 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 boom. That's it. That's it. That's it. Got it. Accuracy first, speed second. Ready, go. Boom, 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 boom. That's it. Got it.
Yeah, me too. Just so you know. Me too.
In the States, we call this one the Ollie Shuffle.
The Ollie Shuffle, yeah. This is the Ollie Shuffle. Boom. Yeah, that's okay. Slow it down. Slow it down first. Right, keep going. Yeah. Switch, replace. Switch, replace. Switch, replace. Switch, replace. There he goes. See out of verbal cueing?
Yeah.
The verbal cueing is everything. Perfect. That's perfect. That's it. Perfect. And you can do the running man move with it just like you're doing, which is cool. That's it. Switch, replace. Switch, replace. Switch, replace. Switch, replace.
I'm gonna get you.
That's okay. Don't worry about it. Go, go, go. Go.
Does the specific order matter?
Yes.
Okay.
And I'll show you why.
So glad you said it.
So I had a good question just seconds ago. The question was, does the order matter? This you can change the order, of course, but you'll notice that if you actually go through this order, it actually serves as a warm-up. You can actually use this as a dynamic warm-up. It's a great dynamic warm-up. It does a lot of different movements, the lower body, not the upper body, mind you, but you could add some things for that. And it goes from smaller movements to larger movements. And that's what we're doing with this. So you're absolutely right. I like this order, but you can tweak it a little bit, but certainly don't start off with high knees. And I'll show you that in a second. The next one is rapid through, one in each. So rapid through, you actually, the cue is rapid through, one in each. And so that means they're gonna go duh, 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 duh. So you're gonna basically go ba 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 is the cueing. So ready? So rapid through, one in each. Go. That was two in each. He switched from one in each to two in each. Okay? No. So everybody, cue it up. Here we go. Cue it up. And one in each. Rapid through, one in each. Say again. Oh, yeah.
Oh, I caught the tweet.
Rapid through, one in each. Pop, 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 pop.
Okay, it's healed now.
I was
good at
it. Jack, see that? I was good at it.
Rapid through.
Rapid through, one in each. Pop, 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 pop. Rapid through, one in each, bup, 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 bup. Now, I had a good question from the peanut gallery, and the question was, what do you do with your arms? And on this one, this, I'd love the people to be a track stars with this, but I don't care initially. Later on, we'll get some arm movements that synchronize to the leg movements. Right now, it's stomping bugs, okay? But later on, we will get something that. Next one, high knees. Can I just have you right up here? Everybody look at this. This is very important to learn how to do high knees. Everybody does it poorly. If you want strength and power and speed coming out of your athletes, which you want, high knees are done like this. So I want you to just do a high knees for me. Just whatever you'd like to do is one in each. High knees, one in each. Yeah.
Okay.
High knees. Good, good. Okay, yeah, stop. So he did the behavior, high knees, one in each. What you want to cue is driving the knee up above the belly button. Not easy. That's a hip flexor maneuver. And then, which is vital to jumping and running. Then the next thing is, you want them to actually drive with their gluteus down. So it's up, down, and importantly, quiet feet on the landing. So it's high knees, one in each, drive the knees high, drive the butt down, and quiet feet. Yeah, you land on the balls of your feet. And you'll get this. So you want to be almost like a prancing horse when you do this. That's what you want to imagine that you are. And some of us prance better than others. Okay? High knees, one in each. Go, give her. Go. Boom, boom. Higher. Drive. There we go. Nicely done. Perfect. Higher, higher, higher. Slower, though. There you go. That's it. Higher, higher. Higher. There you go. Now we get the arms. That's it. High, 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 high. Not so fast. Slow it down. Slow it down. That's it. High. Yeah. Slow it down. Slow it down. That's it. Perfect. One in each. High knees, one in each, yeah. High knees, one in each. There you go, much better, yeah. Like a prance, you can almost feel yourself leaning back. You should almost feel yourself leaning back. There you go. It's not easy to do. Higher knees. So the other cue.
I have a question.
Yep.
So when we were doing this, I noticed that in order for me to get my...
You have to lean back.
I have to lean back.
Yeah.
Would that be a cue or do I let them...
I let them do it. If they're doing it correctly, I would let them go through after a few practices, you can start cueing them. But yeah, they're going to naturally lean back a little bit. If you're a track star, you don't have to because you can actually do it with your upper body. But the lean back is okay.
What are you trying to say?
Well, you're okay.
The arms.
Yeah, you are doing good arms. You are actually doing like the track style. Right. And no, the arms is what you want eventually, but if you try to cue the arms now, they go spaz out entirely. So high knees, one in each. The other thing that you need to know, quiet feet, and then the other cue that you can use, don't have them do this forever, is you can put your hands at your belly button level and actually hit your knees. That forces you to actually drive your knees high enough. Okay? So let's, yep.
Quiet feet.
Oh, just quiet feet. I just literally do that. Just and they learn it slowly. Yeah. Tia, can you come through here for a second? And just can you do high knees, rapid through, one in each, quiet feet? So you actually don't hear the feet very much there? That's very quiet feet. That's quiet enough. That's more than good enough. The next one is a tough one, so everybody come on this way. It's called twisties. So twisties are taught like this. When twisties are done beautifully, they're done beautifully. So here's what happens. On this one, I basically have white, black. So you straddle the white line like this. And the twisting action is, when you teach this, it's bunny hops first. What you're basically teaching is lower body twisting motion is what's going to come from this. But it's a bunny hop. I'm standing here. And then I'm going to go white, black, 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 white, black later on. Accuracy first, speed second. So the action is a bunny hop. Yeah, so you're basically going face, yeah, you're going this way. So it's face this way, turn left, turn left, turn right, turn right, turn left, turn left, turn right, turn right.
Is that cue? Would you use
yes,
that left?
Yeah, absolutely. So you can't, yeah, now watch this, that cue, turn left, turn right, right. Don't do it at the same time of saying white, black. Use one or the other, okay? So whichever you need to do. So let's give it a try here. Go really slowly, bunny hop first. Later on, how it looks. Can either of you two do this well? Do you do twisties? Come on over here. So what you want to do, the end product here, I haven't seen her do this before. The end product is the chest is facing perfectly forward and all the twisting is happening below the hips. Let's see it. There, now see the hips go? She's a salsa dancer, so and speed up. That's it. So see the hips more or less staying forward there? That's later on, and it gets faster than that. Ready? So bunny hop it up.
Okay, so
bunny
turn
hop
left,
first.
Turn left,
turn left, turn right, turn right. No, no, you're always crossing. Yeah, go. Okay. So follow me?
Yeah.
With me?
Left, turn left, turn right. Left, right.
Yeah, keep it going. There, you got it. That's it. And this is, guys, this twisty thing is relative rest, isn't it? It's a coordination relative rest. We just did some high knee passes. This is relative rest.
I wanted to get some cues there.
Yeah.
I wanted to be just
I don't have this at all.
No, you're good.
Sorry.
So I'll go with you. Ready? Huh?
So you're going flat feet, right?
No, you can go toes.
Okay.
You're going to be toes later on. There you go, good. Good twisting. Very good lower body twist here. Very good, perfect, good. No, yeah, here I'll come in front of you. So here, stand beside me on this one right here. Right there, you ready? And we go here, step. Okay, and then we're going to hop it.
Got it.
Okay, cue up with me again one more time. Come on this way. Ready? And yeah, hang on. And go. Hop. 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 Yeah, it's good. You know, here we go. Watch this. White between your legs with me. Block. White. Block. White. Block. White. Block. White. Yeah, don't step out. You always have something between your legs there.
Oh, boy.
That's okay. Here, let me help you. Hang on. Come on. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Okay, I got it.
You got it. There you go. White, white, black, white, black. There you go. That's it. Okay, so listen up. The twisties are relative rest. They also give a coordination effort. The whole team gets together. It's a team building exercise at the same time. Twisties are a great thing to do. We even do them backwards. We do backwards twisties if you really want to freak them out. Everything that we do here, we also do backwards, meaning in and out, out, icky shuffle. You can go backwards. There you go. We'll figure it out. No, it's all good. So the next one is out five times, jump three. And this is variable depending upon the quality of your team. Out five means this. One, two, three, four, five, jump three. One, two, three, four, five, jump three. And then we do jump four, jump five, you name it. Out five, jump three. So you jump clear three or whatever you want. Okay, ready, go. Out five, jump three, yeah, go, fast. Boom, yeah, no, you jump. Yeah, no, you jump from the end. Jump three, there.
Oh, I did.
That's okay.
Just jump five.
There you go. Go for it. Cue it up. And as soon as she jumps, you start. So right behind her. Time pressure, time pressure. There you go. There you go. Perfect. Now you can already see now we're getting some strength development here, some speed. Boom. Be over. And you'll see the progression in a second. And we can progress to jump five. And I have people who jump six, no problems.
When you're, I know it's at the beginning stages with your athletes, but when you're doing it, are you going to encourage them to, on your jump forward, to go out right away?
Yeah, right away. So you slow it down initially. Slow it down initially. Get it really slow. Get them to do it slow properly first.
And
then.
Still be quiet feet on the landing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, quiet feet on the landing, the whole thing. Then you can start working. They got to go at least a pass or two, right, the first time. And then after that, you go, okay, you know, we figured it out. Because I would actually do two passes for the whole team. Get everybody. I wouldn't even correct them almost unless it was really bad. And then the second pass, I'd start a little bit of cues.
And does it matter if they jump from out? Like I noticed.
No, it doesn't matter. It's up to you. You can actually make that jump from out, jump from in. It's irrelevant. You do both in basketball, you know?
Okay, so one more.
Yeah, no, ask away. No, you better off.
Can we vary it? Like,
oh, yeah.
Jump from out, jump from in.
Yeah.
From out, jump
from in. Very cool. I love it. Keep the interest going. But don't make some athletes fall behind because of that.
Right.
Like, don't alienate them. Yeah. Okay, the next one, folks, gets now a little tougher.
Ooh, she jumped nine.
Yeah, she can jump nine. Yeah, I like moving it while you do it. Boom! That's the cue. Boom! There, like a bunny rabbit. Yeah, a little double landing, right? So here we go. She's a soccer player. She doesn't know what she... Yeah. Soccer people, ugh. So here we go. The next one is the same drill, except no five outs. It's continuous. Continuous jump means that we can go continuous jump three. So, booing, go for it. And I'm going, boom, 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 boom. That's it, right there. Go for it. And I see the little boom, 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 the cue. Three, boom, 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 boom. Continuous, go, you fade it. Don't fade on me, don't fade. Don't fade. No fading, guys. Boom, 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 boom. There you go. Nice. Boom, boom, Accuracy, guys. Land in the square.
That's harder than what you think, yeah.
Oh, it's much harder than you think, yeah. Nice. Nice. Good job. And you're gonna show me jump five.
Okay.
All right, in a second.
I noticed that with athletes when I do this, as they pick up speed,
yeah,
they lose their balance.
Retract.
What are some
keys? So you're gonna keep the speed back and say, I don't wanna lose effort. That's why I'm gonna be beside them and going boom, 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 boom. So I'm cueing them, right? So I'm gonna try to control that. So a very good question, guys. I don't want them to fade as they're going through the ladder, and I don't want them to lose their balance by trying to go too fast. I'd rather have you jumping high than jumping fast at this stage. And that slows them down a little bit. But ultimately, you do want, and I don't know, go for jump five. Yeah, go for it. You'll get into it. There you go. We will go to that stage. That's where you want to be with an athlete. That's not inappropriate. You cue that from going threes to fours to fives for the appropriate age and maturation level. The next ones are called crossouts. These are fun. So now a slight de-escalation of the amplitude here. Here are crossouts. Everybody can do it with me. So stand with your legs out like that and over a line, please. So I'm in the out position here. And then I'm going to go out and cross right. My right foot's going to go in front, out, cross right, and you're going to pass the line. Go for it. Out, cross right. Good. Out, cross left. And see, my feet are on either side of the line. Out, cross right, out, cross left. Out, cross right, out, cross left. Everybody got that? This is actually very good for hip muscles, etc. So we're going to do that down the ladder here. So how the ladder works, it's basically out, cross right, out, cross left, out, cross right, out, cross left, out, cross right, out, cross left. Cue it up.
I like it on the line.
Yeah, and the line, yeah. Ready? And out, cross right. No, I always have one in front of you.
Oh, okay.
Out, cross right, out, cross left, out, cross right, out, cross left.
Yeah.
There we go. Okay, go for it. Cue it up, cue it up. Out, cross right, out, cross left, out, cross right, out, cross left. There you go. Out, cross right. Out, cross left, out, cross right, out, cross left, out, cross right, there you go. Out, cross right, out, cross right, out, cross left. There you go. Progress. Yeah, yeah, out, cross right, yeah. No, that's okay, out, cross right, there you go. Perfect. That's nice, there you go. On the toes, ultimately, on your toes. Perfect. Out, cross right, out, cross left. Out, cross right, out, cross left. There we go, and then out. So you do, hang on, I'll track with you, hang on. So hang on, stay with me. And then out, cross left, out, cross right. Perfect. Out, cross right, out, cross left, out, cross right, out, cross left, out, cross right, out, cross left, out, cross right, out, cross left. Go for it. We're developing ankle stability with this as well. Yeah, you can feel that. You do this consistently, and we're sweating already, guys. This is a great little warm-up. So the next one's called the drunken shuffle for age appropriateness and parents in a room. We'll call it the ladder crossing shuffle. So may not call it the drunken shuffle. What's it in the flip chart book? Can you find out what we called it? Because I remember we said, we better not say drunken shuffle. But here's how the drunken shuffle works. So this is a rung, another rung here. And how it works, I'm going to stay away from those. And basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to cross the ladder. Land on that foot. So that is a very strong ankle strengthening exercise. Stay from ladder, keep it slow. Cue it up.
Is the idea over time that you would try and have the body.
Yeah, and you can.
Going to the next one.
Yeah, going to the next one, right. So cross, 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 yeah, cross. Step overs, okay, step overs, there we go. And then you can speed it up as you go, right? Yeah, you're doing two rungs there. One rung.
Is there a cue for your body?
Not yet. No, it naturally comes. It's like throwing a frisbee at the other arm.
But at times, it felt like I was going,
whoa. Well, you were. And yet, because you're controlling speed versus movement. I would actually keep you a little bit slower for you. There you go. Whoa. Stop. Okay, and go for it again.
So, the tendency seems to be to bend the leg.
Yeah.
You didn't bend your knee when you did.
No, I didn't.
So it's doesn't, trying to be more of a...
You can do either way.
Okay.
It doesn't really matter.
Okay.
In the end of the day, what you're doing is you're just getting that, you're getting that landing and then a change of direction.
Okay.
So it's really this landing leg that counts. Whatever the way they like it, I don't mind. Cross. One rung each though, one rung. Otherwise you're going fast. Right, there you go. One rung. So make sure you do one rung, and that makes a big difference. If you do one rung, if you try to do two rungs, you're going for distance. Yeah.
What's the difference in develop, like, what's it working differently
to
go one versus two?
If you go two rungs, you're not really working the ankle stability part of it. So you're really learning the ankle and teaching it how to be strong in a change of direction. If you go two rungs, it's really a speed maneuver. So the next one is single leg zigzags. These are tough. And I wouldn't necessarily do single leg zigzags first off with a team. If you're teaching them, I'd probably stop here. But single leg zigzags will teach you. Zigzags. So what you're going to do is you're going to stand out here and you're going to be on your right leg or your left. Everybody starts the same. And a zigzag is using the ladder. It goes zig, zag, zig, zag. So diagonal across, diagonal across, diagonal across. This is tough on a full ladder. There you go.
So that
one. Yeah.
What is this?
There you go. There you go. Nice. And you can really feel the coordination requirements of this. Yeah, absolutely. If you have two ladders, this makes this world a lot better. But if you have two ladders and doing this end-to-end, a lot of work.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Nice. And you'll see what the foundation of our movement is with this. Nice. Perfect. Nice. Good. Not so far out. Don't try to go so fast. Slow it down a bit. There you go. Follow the zigzagging ladder. It's tough. A full ladder's tough. But they should be able to do this at your age group. Okay.
I'm going to show you my dad.
Once everybody's through here, we'll go on.
Lefty.
Yeah.
Oh.
Don't go too fast. Keep it slow first. Okay, and everybody skips the last two rungs, so where do I stand? On the last two rungs. Yeah, so here's the situation, guys. If you went through this, if you teach it, I'd have them go through a couple times each just to learn it. This is your very first time. And then the second practice, we do it on purpose. Okay, and typically what we do is we go through the entire sequence of them all once, come right back to the beginning, go again. A two pass on a ladder with all these drills doesn't take a long time, two passes. Each one of the drills in sequence. One sequence, then the same sequence over again. That's pretty, you can imagine what that does. Pretty good cardiovascular conditioning, pretty good lower body workout. You can mix and match that with anything else that we do here today. Everybody follow me on that? So this is a really good segment to do. There are hundreds of other ladder drills that you can find online. Pick the ones you like, but think through a little bit. These are organized in a way that they actually give you relative rest and a little bit of different levels. And you can mix and match. If you're getting your team too tired, do something like doing in, out, out, backwards in between, like this. So it gives them a relative rest. You follow me on that? And insert something like that. Okay, so that's the ladder work. Any questions on ladders? Oh, you had a good point. He said, well, why don't I get two ladders, one going up and one going down? If you do that, the relative rest for the team dramatically reduces. If you've got a fit team, 100%. As your team gets better and better, because what's going to happen, we typically do ladder drills at the beginning of the workout, two passes, and at the end of the workout, at the end of your training sessions. Technical, tactical, why? They need to learn, they got to learn how to move in the face of fatigue. So, you cue them, accuracy first, speed second, and then they're tired and they got to do it properly. Got it, yep.
Question on that, when you're doing it the second time,
yep.
You're not doing the same number, or are you cutting it in half? Or you
no, same number, yeah. Nah, this is very good. I mean, alone, this is a conditioning drill, is very, very good. So we're going to move on to the next one right here. We don't have mats, do we? Not accessible. The wall, yeah? We do. Those come down? Okay, everybody quickly grab the wall mats, pull them on down. Well, you're looking, if you actually do it, then you're about 7 minutes. Yeah, I just series. You do one pass or two passes, whichever you like. So grab the mats and put them down here in the middle, guys. You've done some of this stuff with me before. Yeah.
Yes, I have. And then the big one.
So lay them right down anywhere. They're solid. Okay, if we can spin them so they're like this, please, they'll be a lot better for you. Okay, and you can share, you're going to put your elbows on them. So everybody's going to be facing me like sardines, just like Tia right here. Now I'm going to do a very quick core routine, and I'm going to explain why. If I'm a basketball player, the very first thing you teach your players to do is sharpen your elbows, right? Your elbows are a very useful clearing tool in your sport. Here's the answer. This little segment from here to here, is good. From here to here is called your core. Why do we want a strong core? You shoot better with a strong core. You don't get pushed off the ball easy with a strong core. You can push people off the ball easy if you have a strong core. And you run better with a strong core. But it's not doing sit-ups, guys. It's doing stuff like this. I always put this core routine right at the very end. You do your little warm-up and everybody does a core routine. Or you want to throw it in, everybody does their little stuff that we're going to do, some more things, and at the very end of the practice, you get your team captain to lead a team core routine. Then it's kind of out of your face. You kind of stand and watch so they're not cheating, right? So I'm going to teach you good core. Ready? The list is right here in front of you. If you want to, we can look through it. It's listed there. You just want to learn the basic skills. So grab the list. Get one. There we go. I think I have it now. Yeah. So with your list in front of you, put it on the floor in front of you. This is a core routine. This is our level one core routine. We have level one to level 14. If a national team player was in here, they'd be at level three. If I had a national team player, I'd want them to be at level three. Level one is what you're getting today. And it's actually level one in a bit, because I'm giving you a little bit more if you want to use it. So everybody, here's what you do. The commands I'm going to teach you are plank it up when necessary and belly down, which means you put your stomach on the floor and rest. And if I say belly down, I'll mean that. That means you need the rest. So first things are, your elbows are beneath your shoulder. You're going to do a front plank. Ready? Plank it up. So what should be happening there is that your hips are in line with your shoulder, in line with your ankles. You're not butt up. You're not sagging down. Everybody looking good. Okay, belly down. It's no use in doing a 2 minute front plank. We can do that just for fun to watch the eyes bug out and the veins come out and people swear at you. If you really want to do that, watch the trick. I've got 4 or 5 front plank sequences that I'm going to make them do 2 minutes of front planks without even knowing it. So here we go. I'm only going to do 5 seconds. Front plank. Plank it up. Hands apart, please, not triangles. Good, there we go. keep it nice and solid. The next thing I'm going to have you do, stay in this position, is go up, up, down, down. Up, up, down, down. Up, up, down, down. Up, up, down, down, and belly down. If you think about what I'm doing, I'm being hit on the field of play, right? My trunk is being hit on the field of play. I'm learning how to control my trunk. You don't want it to be like a little jelly belly willow tree in there. You want it to be not perfectly solid, but it's got to be moving along with you. So ready? Plank it up. And up, up. Down, down. Up, up. Down, down. Up, up. Down, down. Good. Belly down. So now you've got up, front plank. We do that for 10 seconds. Then we do up, 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 down, down for 10 seconds, or whatever your team can tolerate. The next one is called the pointer. So we're going to be in this position. You're going to shift your weight onto one hand and do this. Now the finger is important. You're going to pretend there's a Chihuahua dog in front of you. It's been trained, so it's not going to bite you. And you're going to take the nose of the Chihuahua and tickle the nose. Your front plank position is not going to twist. You're not going to shift at all, so I'm going to take my arm off, tickle the nose of the dog, and then I can put my arm down, shift over, tickle the nose of the dog. That's called a right arm pointer and a left arm pointer. It looks easy, but it's not. So front plank, shift your weight onto your left arm, and pointer and tickle. Do not twist, do not lift and lower your hips, and go back to front plank, please. Remember that position? Now you're going to shift on the other arm. Do not lose that position. Don't hike up your hip. Spread your legs wider to make it easier. Cheat your hand. Stop, belly down. We're going to cheat. When you front plank, I'm going to have you put your arm right in the middle of your body to make it even easier, okay? So put your arm that you're going to do the pointer on in the middle of your body, plank it up. Now do the pointer. No twisting. Hips are level, guys. Feet should be wider apart. Feet way, there you go, way easier. And what you're looking for here is the hips should not be twisting. There's lots of people doing that. You're falling down already. Do you see the tickle is not easy? The tickle actually has an influence, right? Okay, and down. So we do this. Everybody listen, follow me. Front plank, X number of seconds. If your team is learning, I'd belly down them. We do a front plank for 10 seconds, belly down. Front plank, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, belly down. Front plank, right arm pointer, left arm pointer. Right arm pointer, left arm pointer, belly down. You got me on that? So that's the sequence. Now the next one is going to be the tough one. It's called the Superman plank. So we're going to be in this position. I take my hand, no tickling, my other foot off. That's what you want to get to. You don't need to do that right now. So we're going to do, you ready? Here we go. We're going to go front plank. And you're going to take your right arm and point, no tickle. And your left arm, foot off. And then switch. Superman right, Superman left. Superman right, Superman left. And stop. The way he's doing it, which I was demonstrating to you, is called a dynamic Superman. That's level 3. So let's not get the guys there yet. It's Superman right, deliberately, Superman left, deliberately. Everybody got that? And we can't have both feet and both hands off the ground, otherwise I would do that. It would be fun, eh? Okay, so where are we? We've done plank, up, up, down, down, right arm pointer, left arm pointer, Superman right, Superman left. The next one is side plank. So you're going to put your right arm down, and you're going to go into a side plank position, just like this for me. Everybody facing that basket, please. Maybe, oh yeah, whichever. On your right arm. So your hands down on the ground, your hands in a fist, your elbows directly below your shoulder. Everybody got that? Hands up to the sky, just like everybody's doing. Very good. That's just a simple old plank. We hold that for 10 seconds. That's all funky and cool. I'm going to go to what's called a side plank with a snap rollover. So everybody listen carefully. Plank it up. Hand up to the sky. Bend your elbow 90 degrees on the top. Make a fist. And now that fist, the fist is going to go where your elbow is, and your elbow is going to go where your hand is, and snap roll over, boom. And you're not going to touch the ground. Hand up to the sky, bend your elbow 90 degrees, snap roll over. And belly down and watch me. So I'm in this position here, hand up to the sky, bend your elbow 90 degrees, see this hand? It goes to where this wrist is, that elbow goes down, snap. I'm gonna take this hand, bend 90 degrees, snap, roll over. And in, you want the people to be wobbling and falling over. So now we're gonna do it on purpose. So I'll go through them again right now. Here are the perfect cues. Right arm on down, so right side plank, please. Let's give her. Straight, nice, solid board body. Your hips are not tilted up. And then bend your elbow 90 degrees, put your elbow on the opposite side, snap, roll over, do it quickly. And bend your elbow 90 degrees, snap, roll over. And bend your elbow 90 degrees, snap, roll over. There you go, and belly down. You guys got it. So that's it. Now the next one we're gonna do, you'll notice that even your hips can feel that, because your hips are holding up your body there. We're gonna actually push that a little bit further. I'm gonna teach you why. The muscle inside this part of your butt, right inside there, not the big one at the back, but the one back here is called gluteus medius. It is a cause of many injuries in your sport, ACL ruptures and things like that. I'm gonna show you what happens. I'm standing on my right foot, and this gluteus medius is now holding up my body. If this gluteus medius in the dish of my butt is weak, this is what happens. See that? Not good on my knee. We want really strong gluteus mediuses. We can layer that in here. Watch how we do it. Everybody, right side plank. And this actually isn't on the list. Right side plank. Now what I want you to do is hand up to the sky, and you're gonna take your heel and bring it up to my hand here, like that, and down. Up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Stop. The rule of thumb, and if you're feeling that, it's not easy. If you can't do 5 of these in a row, that's remedial. We want to be able to do 10. So how do we do it? Here's how you layer it in as a bit of exercise for your team. You don't do 10 in a row. You go like this. Right side plank, everybody, quick. Hand up to the sky. And then you go 2 heels to the sky. 1 and down. 2 and down. Snap, roll over. Heel to sky. 1, 2. Snap, roll over. Heel to sky, 1, 2, snap, roll over. Heel to sky, 1. Just follow that. Everybody got that? You feeling your gluteus medius there? You want to emphasize good control as they do it. So not lift up and slap. Everybody, you're feeling a little bit of workout here, I guess. This is good. So we're almost done our core routine. By the way, this takes less than 5 minutes. This entire sequence here is less than 5 minutes when done properly. So the next one, you're gonna follow along with me. We're gonna do, we got lots more to do here, guys. You're gonna sit like me, here's how you teach it. It's called the bent knee V-sit. So you're gonna have your knees bent at 90 degrees. 90 degrees. Your toes up to the sky. Bend at 90 degrees, not long out like that, 90 degrees. You're gonna put your hands out to the side like there's rain falling down onto them. Then you're gonna lean back till your heels come off. Now everybody's gonna be jiggling if you don't do this with me, 15 seconds. This is called a bent knee V-sit, 15 seconds. Everybody jiggles if you haven't done this before. That goes away within 3 training sessions. Heels down, yeah, jello right now. You're seeing this as a pretty significant core routine. You do this every single practice. At the end of practice, your team will have a ridiculous core within 6 practices. This is how fast it changes. 6 weeks, it's phenomenal.
We do them all the time, but let's just say we have practices once a week.
Right.
Is it still?
Oh, absolutely. We do. Oh, I would put this at the end of every practice with a team captain. You're still going to get benefit. One time a week, you still get benefit consistently. And you can say to them, can you do it one time at home, please, realistically? If a high-end athletes I work with, they do it for about 3 weeks every single day. And then 2 or 3 times a week to keep what they got. You got me? So once you keep what you got, you can back it off, but you have it at practice, the team has fun with it. They all sit in a circle and they have fun with it. So the next one, bent knee V-sit, come on with me. So we did that for 15 seconds, now we do this. We grab a grapefruit and we put it into center so nobody can steal it. Then we sky the grapefruit. Then we center, side touch, center, sky, center, side, 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 center, sky, center, touch, center, sky, center, touch, center, sky, center, touch. You follow me on that? That's the next one. It's set that. Do you see all there? It says Bentley V-sit, Bentley V-sit, sky, center, side, center, sky, center, side, center. The next one you do is V-snaps. Do you do V-snaps? No. You do V-snaps? Come on over. I know everybody hates V-snaps. Now, right where we stopped, if we stopped here, that's a level one core routine. Here. V-snaps are added. So, Tia, you want to demonstrate a V-snap? Do you know how to do this? Have you ever done one of these? So, lay back. And what? So I'm going to teach novice here. And what you're going to do is put your hands right above your head, and then you're going to take those hands and your feet are going to touch right here in the middle. Ready? Snap. Go. Good? Right there, though. Good? And back. And go. So bring your feet up better, faster. There you go. That's a V-snap. Got it? So, lay on back. Let's try a V-snap. We're going to do 5 or 10 of these, but we're just going to do 2. Ready? And snap. And snap. And snap. Here you go. You got it. The last one is very, very tough. Who's got unbelievable abs? Huh? Yeah. Well, ideally, when you're really good at this, your head, this part of your head right back here is called the occiput. You don't touch this part, the back bump of your head onto the ground, and you don't touch your hands, nor do you touch your feet. That's the real proper way of doing a V-snap. It is very tough. And slowly over sessions, you teach that, not right away. So the next one, who's got great abs? You want to try it? All Tia, you come here. Come on over here. We're going to do the slams. So just sideways there and then on your butt. There we go. And bent knee. So you got a partner here. We're going to bent knee sit-ups. Come back, bent knee. There you go. Go on back down. These are very tough, but they're fun. So what you're going to do is you can take your hands and grab your earlobes, and you're not going to allow your arms to do that. You're grabbing your earlobes so that if you pull on them, you'll yank them off. So keep your ears. And then you're going to hold on to your earlobes. You're going to keep your hands and elbows off to the side, and you're going to bring your chest and slam them to your knees and just stay there. Slam. Boom. Well, follow instructions. Slam. And then you go halfway back down. Half. Slam. Half. Twist. Twist. Six times. Oh. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and down. Don't touch the back of your head. Don't touch your back. You can touch your back. And now go slam, halfway back. Slam, halfway back. Twist. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and down. That's one. Okay? That's one. Well, we'll do it again because you're having fun. Slam, halfway down. Slam, halfway down, twist. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and down. That's one. You got me on that? Do you want to try that once? Give that a try. Do a couple. Give that a try. And remember, this is level 1.5 I'm giving you here, so. You've never seen it. We've never done this yet, have we?
I've never done it, but you do this with
Jeff. Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. No, that's good. That's good. You remember how to cue it.
That was perfect.
Good. Bigger twists. And stop. Everybody, I want you to think about when you're doing your twists that a pole is right down your spine. So you're not doing chipmunks. Not doing chipmunks. No chipmunks. Big, tall twists like this. You can knees together if you like. Either way you want to do it. Not critical. Not critical. Whichever way you want to do it. Yeah. Whatever works.
Whatever.
This is not easy. Slam, halfway down. Slam, halfway down. No, elbows like this. There you go. There, that's it. That's it. Perfect. Okay, folks. Now we're going to move on. Oh, yeah, it says, I'll tell you all the things. So everybody listen up. Here's the progression. For everything that's not repetitions, you basically do 5 seconds, then 10 seconds, and then you go to 15, then you go to 30. You are finished level one when you can do all these in a row with 30 seconds in a row. Am I going to run out of time here? Okay. So everything that's not repetitions. You go 5 seconds, and then when everybody can do 5, then you move to 10. When everybody can do 10 in a row without bellying down, you go to 15, then you go to 30, then you go, that's it. If you guys get the 30 and can do all this in a row, you've completed a level 1.5 routine. The harder ones are V-snaps and slams. Those aren't typically in a level 1 routine.
You want us to guide the, for the slams?
5.
Do we want the chest to
hit? I want them to hit. Big concentric contraction. Big concentric contraction of your abs. Slam it. Boom. There you go. 5. 5 for the, you want to do 5 for the V-snaps to start, 5 for the slams, and 2 heels to sky if you remember that one. I didn't write that in there, but 2 heels to sky. Okay, now we're going to move on to, can do square drills. I don't think you've done this with me before.
No, I don't think so.
No. So here we go. Can I help me for a sec? Okay, folks. Everybody, come on, stand up over here. Stand on this side of me. So stand right over here, guys, right in this area. Pretty good core routine? Yeah. Your athletes like this, actually. That, because they're not doing really long planks and they're not screaming at you, they like it in general. Your athletes like it? Yes. Okay, so I want one person standing right here and one person standing right here.
Go Adam.
So what I'm going to show is the layout here. These are called squares. They're listed in there. You'll notice what I've done is I've made one square here and another square there. Everybody see that? So you're going to stand on the inside of yours right here.
Am I in this
2 feet?
Square?
Yeah, you're in this square and you're in that square. Okay? So what you're going to do, the squares are basically a movement control exercise. You can put 2 squares beside each other and have a lineup of your team, half team on that side, half team on that side. That's the advanced thing. We're going to do it competitive right now, but we're not going to compete too much, okay? I know it's hard for you guys not to do that. So here's what you do. Starting that position, you're going to go, starting by touching that pylon, and then you're going to come here and touch this one. Then you're going to go back, then sideways touch this one, back touch that one, sideways touch this one, back touch this one. You got that? Front, diagonal, side.
But always back.
Yeah, and always back to where you're, and you must touch the pylons. Let's do it slowly first. Ready, go. Go touch. Yeah, it doesn't matter. I don't care, whatever way you like. And what you're trying to do is learn economy of movement here. So if you're stepping outside like this and doing this, you're moving way too far. So you really want to be, when you're on the diagonal, you should be doing this, right? See that movement there? See the loading of the knees? And then back to the side. Economy of movement. That's what you're trying to teach. So you want to become like little robots. So when we're doing this, without the competition side, we'll do it 3 times in a row. So both of you are going to do the thing 3 times in a row. Be efficient. Ready? Go! And they'll learn how to do their footwork. They'll learn how to do footwork. And see, he's got some twisting going on there, etc. You'll figure it out. And it is very difficult. And stop. Now, you'll notice if we switch positions, it's actually different. Because you're actually moving, you're starting off moving off from one side. So you would actually switch here. Now, if you had a lot of pylons, I'd set up a whole bunch of these with teams, and then I'd say, I'd have them all ready to go, sets of 2 with, now watch this, you 2 can be doing sets of 3, and I have another set here. You follow me? That would be 4 people on this station. Then I have another station over there. Got me on that? That's 8. I have another station over there, I got 6, 12, then I got 16. What's the roster on a basketball team? 12? Yeehaw. Okay, one. Well, you want to actually, you guys want to try it? You guys back out. Yeah, you could, absolutely. But here's the problem. If you have it a competition, we'll do it with a competition. You guys get in there. I'm going to have them compete now, which is fun. And what you're going to do is you're going to have a competition. They're going to be running at each other in the end, right? Right? Because they're going to be coming back this way. So you have to have a separation between them. So let's give it a try. Well, when you're finishing, you're going to be running towards each other so you can impact. You'll see what I mean. You're going to do it as fast as you can right now. Touch, starting with a touch. Ready, go! No, wrong, stop. Forward, diagonal, side. Come on back. Come on back, quick, 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 quick. Ready, go! Come on, diagonal. Side. And now that's it. And you'd be running at each other. You see? Yeah, that's why. Okay, so that's the competition version of it. But initially, we're teaching them to become like robots. And they're learning their footwork. There's a lot of footwork here. Everybody, just try it once. Come on into the squares, try it once. So line up, just do forward, diagonal, side. Go for it. Good, yeah, good, nice. To the side, yeah, side, touch. Good, side, touch, touch, good, that's it. Next, good. Do with purpose, guys, touch, touch, with purpose. That's it, you have to touch it, that's it, nice, there you go. Stepping outside, right? Don't step outside, you're going too far. Go for it. Don't step way outside. Yeah, yeah, exactly. So I'll explain some of the features. Yeah, with the big steps. Touch. You gotta touch them. Once everybody's tried it. Okay, give it a try. Go, boom, boom. Go, fast. Come on, that's it. Back, diagonal. Diagonal, touch it. Diagonal, touch it. Sides, touch it. And back, there you go. Nicely done. Okay, so everybody listen up. When we're doing the squares, we're looking for economy of movement, not overstepping. If you think about this, there's a large amount of trunk motion as we're doing this, so we're strengthening up our trunk as well as our lower body, as well as our some of our dynamic flexibility, all at once. And you can progress this to being competitive if you want. If you're competitive and you're doing this, make sure you switch sides, because it actually is quite different if you do it rightward or leftward. So balance it out.
Like there's economy of movement.
There's bigger strides. Don't step out. Yeah. Don't step out. Touch. Reach down and touch.
Talk about your levels. You said there's a lot of trunk.
Yeah. If you're moving up and down like this, you're not efficient. So there's, yeah. Okay. We're going to move on to the next one. This is another footwork drill. This is called the weave. And it's really handy because this is set up for it right now. Okay, so this is a big drill. I'm going to show you the layout. It's not very difficult. Look at the lanes here, guys. Lane 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See that? So how this works is called a weaving drill. This is a cutting practicing drill to reduce the injuries of ACL. It's also great conditioning. So there's weave right and weave left. The whole team can be doing this on purpose at the same time. So I'm going to take the two physios in the room here. I'm going to take you as well as you. And come on, stand over here. Stand right here in a line, facing backwards, all four of you, right here. Face me. Face me. This one's a little bit narrow, but I'm going to keep it this way. I'd have it a little bit, these pylons just a little bit further. So what we're going to do here is you're going to come towards me, wait, and he's going to come past the pylon, and here's the cues, very important. He's coming towards me, and he's going to go plant, plant, diagonal here, plant, 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 back, and then he runs to here. Ready, go. Plant, 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 plant. As soon as this person goes, plant, plant. Come on, plant, plant. And no, forward, plant, plant. Come on, plant, plant. Go backwards, come on. Plant, plant, go back. Plant, plant. Seated differences, stop. Seated differences in their planting techniques. There's a whole bunch of telegraphing going on there, right? The stutter steps coming in, very unbalanced. So watch the cues here, and this is very relevant. As you get better, I stand right here with a little bit of distance so their feet go here. I'm not going to worry about that. If I have additional coaches, I might have plant, plant people, but I'll move back there later. Come on. Plant, plant. Come on towards me. Plant, plant. Not too hard. Plant. Go at 80%. Come on. Plant, plant. There we go. Plant, plant. See the cue? Plant, plant. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. You get the idea? Okay, so now watch as I progress this. Watch what I do. I'm now standing here. She's going to come in towards me. I've given her physical encroachment on these. Come on, let's go. Plant, plant, fast. Plant, plant, come on, right in. Plant, plant. Come on, right to my face. Come on, step on my toes, I don't care. Plant, plant. You see the maneuver right there? And I can have the whole team doing this. So everybody, come on up. Everybody in a line. Adam, can I borrow you? Can you take all these pylons and just move them about that far? Okay, ready? Come on. Plant, plant. 80%, guys, diagonal. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. Diagonal. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. Diagonal. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. Pass the pylon. Plant, plant. Don't telegraph. Plant, plant. There you go. Watch your knees bend in. Plant, plant. There you go. Plant, plant. There you go. Come on. Plant, plant. There you go. Plant, plant. There you go. And plant, plant. Plant, plant. Plant, plant, go back, diagonal, left plant, plant, yeah, yeah, that's way, plant, plant. You get that? That's good. Yeah. So, if you realize this, I've got now a whole bunch of the team moving in space at once, right? And I got, that's a good thing. There's not a lot of sitting around for this drill. We just weaved right. Now we're going to go on to this side. Come on down. And you start here, everybody. And now you're going to go, now it's going to be right, left, plant, plant, plant. Ready, go. Plant, plant. Go back, diagonal. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. There we go. Plant, plant. I don't want stutter steps, guys. Plant, plant. No stutter steps. You're telling me you're changing direction. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. There we go. Plant, plant. Plant, plant. There we go. Plant, plant. There we go. Plant, plant. Yeah, no stutter. Plant, plant. And stop. Everybody listen. When you're doing this, what you're looking for is overreaching knees like that. Not a good thing. Knees planting in like that. Not a good thing. If you step way out like that, you're telling me you're going that way. That's also a telegraph, right? So you want to have a nice uniform plant-plant behavior. It's not perfectly symmetrical. And you want to become like a robot. And similarly, I'll stand back here. As they're coming back in a diagonal, I'll be behind them reinforcing the plant-plant, the change of direction from backwards to forward, the change of direction from forwards to backwards. Weave right, weave left. Who is that? Nick? All right. Yep.
If you have athletes that are...
There's a billion different things you can say. So when you're doing this skill, you guys who are doing it with serious purpose as you're going through, what we do, let's go slow first. So we might do 5 passes, and I'm going to say, go slow, get the pattern down first. So you take the time pressure and speed pressure off. And then what happens is you go, we're going to speed up, speed up, speed up, speed up at purpose. You got me? That's typically the way. Then you can give them lots of cues. You don't want overreaching, and you don't want knees dropping in like that. You just talk them through, and you give them feedback every single time. I can actually do that. It'll take time, but if you're not controlling it now, you now have the ability to control it. If you can't do it without the ball, how on earth can you do it with the ball? Right? So the next one is a fun one. Can I just come on over this way? One person here. It doesn't matter, just right up. So this is the fun version of it. It is you're going to come towards me, and here's the cue. It's called the plant, plant, 180. So you're going to come, and then not quite yet, you're going to go plant, plant, turn into the pylon. So we're always running forward. Watch this. Plant, plant, turn into the pylon. Plant, plant, turn into the pylon. Plant, plant, turn into the pylon. Plant, plant, turn into the pylon and back around. Everybody give it a try. Plant, plant, 180. Do it slow first. There you go. Plant, plant, 180. Plant, plant, turn into the pylon. So, plant, plant, turn into the pylon. Plant, plant, turn into the pylon. Plant, plant, turn into the pylon. There you go. Plant, plant, turn into the pylon. 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 Plant, plant, turn in. No, no, no. Come on back. Plant, plant. So, plant, plant, turn in. Plant, plant, turn in. Got it. Plant, plant, turn in. Yeah. Plant, plant, turn in. There you go. Plant, plant, turn in. Plant, plant, turn in. No, no. Plant, plant, turn in. This way. There you go. Plant, plant, turn in. Plant, plant, turn in. Plant, plant, turn in. There you go. Plant, plant, turn in. Good. So, if you're thinking about this, guys, you put together the ladder drills, then you make them do squares, then you make them do weaving drills, they're dripping. You have a very serious cardiovascular conditioning, you've got a real agility training, you've got footwork training, you've got strength training. We're not even done yet. You can mix and match these a whole bunch of different ways. Very powerful so far. And trying to reduce injuries at the same time. So we're now going to go over to, we're almost done. We're only missing some of the speed drills now. No, and strength. So everybody off this way to the bench. So just spread those benches apart, just like this. And everybody follow along with me. We've got another 30 minutes of this or so to go. Here's the game, guys. This is item 3, which is bench drills, which isn't all bench drills. This is very serious lower body strength training without any equipment whatsoever. Very serious, very beneficial. You have to mix and match correctly. If you did this entire program with people at the very first time, you'd be overdoing it. We do bits and pieces, then start putting them together, change it up for variety's sake, etc. So if you have 2 practices a week, you got a great opportunity here. So we're going to do some things. First off, everybody in place, stay away from the pylons, please. And what I want you to do, item A, is split squats for height. So we're going to be in this position with our trunk more or less vertical and our knee coming closer to the ground. And split squats for height is like this. And you go for height. So jump. Boom. Boom. So it's not speed. Boom. High. Boom. High. Boom. High. Boom. High. You got that? That's split squats for height. B, same position. Split squats for speed. Boom, 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 boom. Ready? Go. But yeah, no, no, no. Not little slaps. It's going to be from this position. Boom, boom, boom. That's the speed that I want. And full on distance. Trunk upright, guys. Stop. Split squats for height. You're starting off with a team. You do 5 to each side. Then you do split squats for speed. 5 to each side. That's 10 total. Next one. Everybody come on to the benches, and I'm going to have one person. Can you just grab onto the bench like this? Right, like I am? Good. Both feet on the other side. This is called double leg hopovers. Ready, go. Boom. And when you're progressing it, this is what you do. He's good at it. Stop for a second. I want you to just grab on. And when you're progressing it, you start this way. You go, I want you to hop over and land like Spider-Man. Go once. Good. Go. And back. Spider-Man. Good. And do it again. Now a little faster. Faster. Okay, that's how you do it. Because the first person, when they do it, they're going to get a little second bunny hop in there. I don't want that bunny hop. It's like you did it, you want to get them to the continuous. Boom, boom, go, go, now go continuous, boom. But you start them off with the Spider-Man thing. So they don't do the bunny hop. Can you do the bunny hop? Yeah, that one I don't want. That's not suitable for your sport. You follow me? So everybody give this a try. Double leg bench hop overs. You have one on each end, please. And yeah, and then come this way a little bit so your feet are have to actually clear. There you go. And then faster if you can do it. Boom, 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 boom. There you guys, perfect, you guys got it. It's not easy. Yeah, oh, that's right. No equipment necessary. Oh, nobody else, no takers? Okay, can I come on back here? The next one, single leg hop overs. So he's gonna pick a leg, everybody watch, and single leg, and go and land once. And land once. And land once. Now with purpose, boom, 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 go. Boom, 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 boom. Now switch legs. Now I wouldn't normally switch legs on the fly like that, but I knew we could do it, so it was all good. So everybody try single leg hop overs if you want. You do not need any weight training equipment. No, it doesn't matter which leg, because you're always going to be disadvantaged. Oh, careful. Move forward quite a bit more. Yeah, we'll never hit your knee then.
Come on, Jay, get in there.
Okay, next one, walking lunges, guys. The next one is walking lunges. We stand, we basically take a giant step out, and here's the cueing for this. The toes in front of the knees, okay? Not critical, but toes in front of knees. Now we go down into this position, and then from this position, we take a giant step forward like that, and giant step forward, and keep on going. So I want two rows of people, everybody down on this end, please. Way down here. Yeah, just don't have the, I mean, it's not that critical because you're landing that way and all the different ways in basketball anyway, right?
Okay, okay.
So physios will try to say, oh, keep your knees, nose, toes lined up, forget it. But you try to, the big lunge is what you want. So everybody, two lines right here, and I'm going to be doing a trucker walks, two lines, one line here, one line there. Everybody line up, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. And then everybody's going to be, come on, you split up the lines here. And we're going to be doing it as a group, you know, on purpose. Trucker walk. Ready? Go. Walk it up. Big, long steps. Trunk upright. Trunk upright. Go right behind him. Do like a team here. Funeral procession. Ready? Go. Big steps. Big, giant steps. Step it out, guys. Keep your trunk upright. Keep your trunk upright. Trunk upright. Trunk upright. Trunk upright. There we go. Big steps. Bigger steps. Giant steps. 20 of them in a row, that's 10 to each side. Turn around and come back down the middle. Turn around, come back down the middle, or down the side, whatever you can do. Doesn't matter, we'll stop, I think you got it. Okay, next one. I think everybody's got that. Is Bulgarian squats. Put your feet up on the ledge, and then you're gonna step out until that toe's in front of the knees. And you're gonna go down, straight down like this until your knee touches, and back up, and down and back up. You follow that? Give it a try. Everybody give it a try? Bulgarians? No. You can do it off of the bleachers, etc. You can do it. Careful now. Your knee, and then step out farther than you think, so that your toe's in front of your knee. And then you bring your knee almost to the ground. Almost to the ground. Oh, what's quadriceps, okay. Mostly. Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, because I'm feeling it over
there. No, it's quads and hips.
And you're trying to emphasize
keep straight up. And knee, it's very tough. It's tough. We don't have any boxes, so we can't do that one. Okay, everybody listen up. You put all these together, you've got a very serious strength training routine. Very serious, no equipment. Hardcore. I can add more, but let's just leave it at that. The next one is speed. This is what we're going to finish up on. It's item two, accelerations. First things first, these yellow things back up on the wall, please. Adam, can I borrow you for a sec?
Yep.
Yes, I just need two pylons, actually. So you save two, don't let me take those two.
Bad time to roll my ankle out.
I'll grab those two here. The basketball court is how wide? Long. All right. So everybody down at the end of the court, and please move your stuff from out of this region, please.
Hey, I want you to do a ladder.
We can do more ladders. Okay, folks. Yeah, you feel that?
But I feel it like back here. Just
oh yeah, there's hamstring. There's a hamstring component too. It's every muscle we're working. Everybody down here at the end, please. Oh yeah, you need them all to balance it out. So four lines, please. So four sets of people across, and then stack them up behind. One, two, three, four, good. And then line up behind, please. Equalize the lines. So this is item two, which is accelerations. These are designed to enhance speed. I'm going to give you a number here so you can understand this. Harder to do it in this space, but you could. If I look at your fastest player on your team versus your slowest player on your team, what people don't understand is the following. I do it with all the teams I work with. I have them all line up here on the line. You don't do it right now. And I say, everybody knows the fastest person. Everybody knows how slow they are relative to that person. And I say, the people who are slower from the starting line where we are now, take a step or two, or possibly three steps, so that when I say go, at halfway or maybe three quarters of the way down the court, you all cross the line at the same time. Most of the athletes, when they do that, will take one, two, and sometimes two and a half steps, but that's way too much. So what typically it is, now watch what I just said, and then I say, go! And everybody goes, and pretty well all of them cross line at the same time. And what I just convinced every athlete of is that they're only a step to two steps behind the fastest player. So if I can change your speed by one or two steps, that's the ball in your hand or not. So all of these drills are designed to give the half step to one step advantage. There's a lot to this, and most of it comes with, and I'll give you an example. In basketball and soccer, I'm in this position, and all of a sudden I need to move forward, and I do this. That's two steps. If I do this, that's not two steps. It can be just the change of direction why we do these drills. So a lot of this is learning. These next things are teaching a person to be dynamic. You guys call it quick feet, right? What's your cues in basketball for feet? What do you say to the person? On the balls of your feet? Yep. Yeah? And you go, okay, we'll live with that. So here we go. We're going to run up to those pylons. So you're going to accelerate in groups of four from where you are up to the center court, basically. And I'm not going to teach running style yet, but here's what you're going to do. It's going to go a drop and go start. So you're going to stand, you're going to go on your belly, and then pop right back up and accelerate up to halfway. Ready? And then you go peel back so you don't get in anybody's way. Going to start again. Drop to your belly, then go. Go! And then go up. Go! Quick, next. Ready? Go! Drop to your belly. Go! Go! Belly down and go! Belly down, go! And back into your lines, please. So you do this a few times, and what you're doing is teaching a person to be accelerating from any foot position that they can possibly muster. It's not like, this means nothing in basketball, guys. There's very few times that that's the case. All I'm doing is creating a random starting foot position with this, and all the rest of the drills I'm doing the same. Yep.
And this would be different from just starting on the ground?
Absolutely. You can do that. You could just start on the ground if you want, but ultimately, falling and falling recovery is part of your game. So I'd rather learn how to hit the floor, man. So next one is twisties. So everybody, I want you to take your left foot and put it on your starting line. And we're going to do a twisty. So it's going to be twisties two. So it's going to be one, two, and then go. So everybody just do one, two, but don't go. One, two. Go one, two, and then you're going to go. Okay? So from that position, ready, go. Ready, go. Ready, go. Ready, go. Ready, go. Good. Line up, guys. Quick, quick, quick. Next grip. Come on, let's get on the line, guys. Next one's twisties three. Twisties three changes the foot that you start with, right? So three twisties. Ready, go. One, two, three, bam. And go. One, two, three, go. Full twisties. Go. One, two, go. Sorry. Three of them, guys. Go. Okay, back to your positions. No, I want you technically, and I'll correct it later on, I literally want the full rotation like this, not like this. Okay, ultimately. Right. And what you're teaching the person to do is push off of one foot or the other. Twisty twos is one foot, twisty threes is the other foot. They just don't know that. You don't tell them that, they'll figure it out. All right? Next one. I'm going to do 5-5-5s. What you're going to do is 5 tuck jumps, 5 push-ups, and then 5 burpees and go. Now, in the most elite level, I'm going to do 5 tuck jumps and go. That's it. It's actually more difficult if you go straight from tuck jumps to go. So, tuck jumps, can you come here for a second? I'm going to show you a proper tuck jump. This is not a tuck jump, okay? I look like a fairy when I do that. I do cross-dress at night, but not for that purpose. So, tuck jump means I'm going to hear both his knees hit his chest in the air. Let's hear that. Let's do it. Good. And he had heavy feet. So, hit your chest, light feet landing. Ready, go. Yeah. This time do it again, but hit your chest. That's a tuck jump. All right? Not the little things that you're going to attempt to do right now. Okay? So, we're going to try this. 5 tuck jumps, 5 push-ups, 5 burpees, and accelerate out. Ready, go. 5 tuck jumps. Up to your chest, quiet feet. 5 push-ups. 5 burpees. And then, yeah, wow is right. And then accelerate out. Yeah. Go.
Come on, Colton.
Real tuck jump, guys. And I go, yeah, go.
I know my limits.
And accelerate out. Accelerate. There we go. There we go. And out. Good. Go. That's 5. So the last part we're going to do, now if you're with a team, I'd control the start and stops of that a little bit better, but I want you to get the feel of it, that this is not trivial in any way, shape, or form. There is a cardiovascular fitness component of this, there is a sprint component of this, there's a strengthening component of this. All are good. The last one we're going to do is we're teach you some sprint style. So I want the 4 groups to come a little bit closer to each other. You're going to run in groups of four, and I'm going to teach you some basic movements first. So we're not going to do A drills and B drills and C drills like they would do in track, but the more you learn about sprinting in real life, it does translate onto the floor. And no, you don't run like a sprinter on the floor. I accept that. But the better sprint form you have, the better speed you have. So here's the game. When you're doing the running, you're going to teach yourself on how to drive your knees high, and we're going to do that by doing a basic drill right now. So we're going to be doing this one. So see this little drill right here? Backstreet Boys could do it. See what I'm doing here? Let's everybody do this with me. Come on, do it. Knee high, opposite arm, opposite leg. Drive the knee high. Kick your knee up so high that your other foot is coming off the ground. Drive, drive, drive. Stop. Now, this hand is bringing a beer to your mouth. You may say taking a sippy cup to the younger group. Okay? So, beer in mouth. Now, the opposite arm is actually such that the back elbow is at that angle. You're driving it up so high that it's actually horizontal. 90 degree elbows. So let's try it in space again. Sip the cup, not high, not like this. Sip the cup, boom, 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 boom. That's good, nice, yeah, better. You guys aren't bad, we got a dance team going. Okay, now hold on, we're not quite done yet. When you're gonna do this, we're gonna start in this position, and I'm gonna have you jump off the line, literally jump off the line, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna stay leaning forward, looking down at the ground, and count one, two, three, four, five. And one, two, three, four, five is five steps, that's what's gonna happen. And from one to five, you're gonna slowly bring your trunk up. You're not gonna go leaning down and go pop up. You're gonna lean. And you're gonna lean like you're almost gonna think you're gonna fall flat in your face. And if you do, bonus. Prefer not to. So, I'm not over cueing now. Lean forward, drive your arms and your knees. Ready, go! Next group. And I'm not correcting yet. Go! Next group. Go! Lean! Go! Lean! And back quickly. Jog recovery. Four on the line, please. And this time, concentrate on the lean. I'm gonna be watching this time. Up to me, you're looking down. You are not, you won't hit me though. Looking down, driving your arms, sippy cup. Drive the back arms, drive your knees. Ready, go! Drive, 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 that's it, yes. Go! Drive, 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 yes! Go! Lean, go! Okay, hold it. So everybody, once we're back in place, that little drill, as silly as it seems, is important where we're doing the standing drill. We're gonna do a different one right now. We're gonna do high knees, one in each, staying in place. Remember what you do? Like on the ladder drill, high knees, one in each. So you're gonna think, drive your knee up high, but bring it down, quiet feet. Ready, in place, ready, go. High knees. Come on, above your belly button, knees above your belly button. Everybody do it. And stop. Feel that drive? That's the drive you're gonna add to the sprint now. Ready? In your position, leaning forward. Go, drive, 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 drive your arms. That's good. Go. Drive, drive, drive. Go. Lean down, go. Excellent. That's a lot of cues. So those are the drills, and nobody's really unhappy here, you'll notice. So if you're not bored and unhappy, they're not gonna be bored and unhappy. Now, as opposed to doing sprinting drills, this gives you a lot all in one. I can do much more rigorous sprint drills, but if you leave the technical part to what I just left there, only a couple of those, they get it after a while. And literally, over the course of like X number of sessions of this, 6 weeks times two, typically people drop their 40-yard dash in this, in your age group, not your age group, in the age group that you teach by about 0.2. 0.2 is one full stride ahead of the person you were before. Okay?
So this when in practice, at the beginning?
You can do, as a matter of fact, this is, you do, you mix and match all these for 20 minutes. And then you can put some in the core at the end. You put any of this together in any way you want. The leg workout, I would say this, if you have a big scrimmage happening where it's serious level, don't do the strength training component right before that. Everything else is fair game. It's conditioning, guys. And then they get more and more conditioning, and then you put something at the end like the core. You know, and you can mix and match. It doesn't take long to do all of this, but you can mix and match it whatever way you like. And you have to do it based on your time. 20 minutes, you can give 30, bonus. 20 to 30 minutes we'll give twice a week, we'll give a progression for everybody. They're learning the skills at the same time that they're getting stronger and faster and a better core. Any questions on this? Yep.
Would you ask athletes to slow down? Like a lot of times when they're about to start, they'll do...
Yeah. So good point. So if you ever see that, that's what we're trying to get rid of automatically by not even having them thinking about it by doing those twisty drills. Yeah. They'll get rid of that behavior. And they'll get rid of that behavior by doing the weave. There's a whole bunch of ways that that gets rid of. If you actually, so one thing I'm looking at here is when you're starting in this position, I don't see that on any of you. But if I did see it on a person, I would try to say, jump out of the blocks. That's how you get rid of that. Jump. Literally jump. So let's just try that. So four people just accelerating using your best sprint form you have. I want you to imagine jumping out of the box. So that means you get down and go, jump. Jump out of the box. I got one person, come on. We're getting tired. Go, jump, jump. Literally leap out, everybody. Come on, get in line there. Ready? Oh yeah, one more. It's you three. Ready and go, jump. There, that's good. So I think we covered everything. So can you see this in your athletes? This is train to train to compete. And if you can keep on working this together and doing more and more reps, you basically got a pretty serious workout, whatever way you like. There's no magic. You can drop any exercise you want, add any one you want. And these are known to work, and they'll give you pretty rapid results overall. Twice a week, for sure. Once a week, okay, I'd do it. Twice a week, bonus. Beginning and end of practice, why not? You could actually put a lot of the drills in the front and then do my favorite, ladders, weaves, squares in the front, and then ladders, core at the end. And then mix and match. Right? They'll all know each of the routines, and then they say, what are we doing today? You can go squares, weaves, and ladders. Go. Set it up. That's it. They know all the routines. And you can write it down on the board or whatever, and they can do it on their own. And you watch, make sure they're doing good. Correction is important. I can't give you all the cues today, but I think we got a lot of them. All right? Any questions, comments so far? Useful? Now, if you're really good, so come on over. So we're just going to do a 20 pound flak jacket.
Putting it on?
Yeah, put that 20. It's light.
As much as I do.
Yeah. No, I'm just joking. The reason why I bought the flak jacket is just for penalizing somebody if they're really bothering me, but you weren't. The use of flak jackets at this age group, up to 16, 17 years old, very sparing, guys. And if anything, I wouldn't use them at all. You can do way more good for the team by doing everything that we're doing here. Plyometrics, there's tons of plyos here. You're doing plyos on those benches. You don't need to do big plyos. I can show you some plyometrics that are appropriate for your group, that all of this will enhance jump training. All of these skills will enhance power for vertical. There is one skill, we just don't have anything in the room, because you guys don't have plyo boxes, do you? Like small ones about that high? Any of you have that? You do? There is a couple of drills I can show you. We don't have anything in this room that'll do it. Is there any plyos in here? Plyo box? Too dangerous for what I need to do. There are some basic plyo drills, and maybe, oh, we do? Oh, perfect. Oh, this is a big one. Oh, serious. I like that. Thank you very much. This is about twice the height of what I'd want it for the level of the team that you guys have. So I would have one that's this high, about 9 inches. A step is 7, 9 inches high. But I'll show you a skill anyway. I need a volunteer. So the skill that is very useful to do for development of verticals is the following. We didn't do these before, but I'm going to show them to you, not in a box quite yet. You're going to do, and very good for jump height, you're going to do a single leg tuck jump. Do it again. Hit your chest. Do it again. Switch feet. Very different, right? You wonder why I see the asymmetry there? It telegraphs to the athlete that are completely asymmetrical. You got layup right, left. You need drive on both sides. He's not even close to driving on both sides. He's very good. So that fundamental skill right there, if you can teach it properly, is very powerful. Very powerful. So you do the same thing you do the double tuck jump, but you do single. Then you know what we do? We get everybody to bring in a Shreddies box. Mine's Captain Crunch, okay? I bring in a Captain Crunch box, no joke, and you take the goodies out, okay? So you just take the box, and you now put the box here, and then you do single tuck jumps over top of the box. So let's pretend that there's a Shreddies box right here, and you're gonna do single leg jumps right, left. So hold it, let's pretend the line is the box, so you're gonna go on either side of the line. So this way.
Oh, I got you.
Yeah, gotcha. Good. Good. And if you hit the box, there's no consequence. So don't put the Shreddies in there, that's a consequence. Right? Do you follow me on that? That is serious development. Single leg tuck jumps and single leg cereal box jumps. You've got a team that's that good, you get them to do that. That's way before even this. But you got a 9-inch box, here's where we go. Come on over. So there's a whole bunch of drills we do on here. Jump on. Good. Now I'm going to have them jump off, Spider-Man land. Ready, go? Jump off, Spider-Man. Spider-Man. Good. 180. Jump on. Jump off, Spider-Man. 180. And I want a dynamic 180 next time. There we go. Jump on. Jump off, Spider-Man. Do it again. Jump on. Jump off, Spider-Man 180. Very good. Everybody got that? Pretty simple. Watch the next one though. Jump on. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to say jump off, 180 off, land, Spider-Man. 180 off, land, Spider-Man. Got that? Jump on. Jump off, 180 off, Spider-Man. Okay? Now watch this one. This is what you want to get to with a 9-inch box. Here we go. Jump on, jump off, 180, right back up on. Go. No.
That
boom.
Yep.
Now, boom. There we go. Boom. Right? You can feel it? See what you want there? This is way too big for your level. 9 inches. If you really want to do plyometrics, that is the real rapid, dynamic, reactive, sort of powerful jumps. You got me on that? But you can do a lot of it with single leg work. Okay, good enough. I think we're done for today. I'm going to hang out over there if you need to ask me some questions, and thank you very much. Thank you. Thanks, guys.